actually worked.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back. I need to start off this video today by telling you a little story about when my wife and I were camping with our kids in the woods. Now, apparently we had enough reception because I got a notification that my friend Mark Rober posted a video on the world's largest super soaker. So I went over to check out his video and it absolutely blew my mind. Not only did he make a monster super soaker, he made one that actually works. But that's not even the funny part. I literally laughed out loud when he said he put links in the description for anyone who wanted to try making something similar.
I'll put a link to the CAD files we made along with a build list of all of the components we used in the video description if you want to make something similar. If you want to make something similar.
If you want to make something similar.
Who in their right mind would actually make one? Well, we did. Welcome to the Nitro Pressure Random Blaster 5000. This thing's over 4 feet tall, 7 feet long, and slings water at 2400 PSI. But rather than taking 6 months to build, we were able to put it together in 6 days. Let me show you some of its features. We made the handle grips for the gun out of diamond-plated floor matting. The rest is built out of foam, all hand-carved foam, painted with house paint and then sprayed with black and yellow paint to match the King of Random colors. The trigger here is mainly for decoration. The button that actually shoots the water is right up top here, and when you press that, it shoots out a burst at 2400 PSI. That's a lot of pressure. That's like explosive pressure. Piggybacking off Mark's design, we used a pressure washer nozzle so we could get a long, thin stream that would last longer, or you can change out the nozzle to something wider that dumps all the water very quickly, making it a true super soaker. The barrel is just made of a cardboard tube filled with great stuff and 1-inch PVC where we can run the pressure washer line to the end. We did a little quick graphic design and we used a vinyl cutter to make the King of Random Super logo as well as the Nitro Pressure Random Blaster 5000 on the side here, which I think looks really cool. And down here we did our best to imitate the original Super Soaker but changing the name to Random Corp 2017. The water system on the inside functions on the same principles as Mark's design. We have two oxygen tanks, one that's filled with high pressure nitrogen and the other that's filled with water. The only difference is rather than using a regulator and an actuator to get the stream water flowing, we found a little device that does it all for us. That makes everything a little more simple, a little more compact. One of the things that surprised us when we went to build this is the instructions that were posted in the description weren't actually very clear. So really we just referenced the videos, used some artistic and creative license, and tried to replicate it as best we could. Now theoretically we could have built this bigger and made the world's largest super soaker, but instead we decided to build ours an inch smaller than Mark so he could still retain the world record. However, we did make the tank a little bit bigger so it'll hold more water. This thing is already locked, loaded, and ready to fire. Watch what happens when I pull the trigger. Or press up on the trigger, as the case may be. We should water the plants. Ooh, rainbow. Rainbow maker. That's cool. And not only that, we actually made a little tripod stand to set it down on, so we have to hold it all day, because this thing is heavy. As we were putting this thing together, I went back and watched Mark's video, and he tried shooting things like watermelons, hot dogs, soda cans, things of that nature, to demonstrate the power of the water shooting out the nozzle. So we went down to the store and picked up the same items ourselves so we could put them to the test and see how our results compare. All right, now that you've seen our Super Soaker King of Random style, let's pressure it up and see what it can do. Quick connect. All right, next up, high-powered watermelon blast. We need something to back that. Thank you. We got watermelon guts everywhere. Look at that tube. All right, next up, soda cans. I just blew that right over. Soda can is going down. Oh, it got me. Oh, it got me again. Wow, that was awesome. Do you see the way it took out those soda cans? Like, I had to place it on that one for like maybe 2 seconds, and then it ruptured all over my face. You can see the remnants on my glasses right now. So I went for the second can, it exploded as well. The third can exploded, and we still had enough water pressure to slice halfway through a watermelon. That was pretty cool. Okay, we'll do the hot dog next then. Oh, it actually worked. It sliced and diced every single one of them. Did you see that? It's like rolled out of my hand and that is incredible. I literally dropped those from like 1 inch high and they went through the beam, which was apparently so strong, it just ripped them all in half. So yeah, hot dogs, big win. That was a lot of fun, all at once. And they smell delicious. I think I'm gonna take these home and cook them up for dinner because those are amazing. This stuff still looks half edible. It's a really interesting texture on the top where it was cut. It almost tastes like it's burned if it's possible, but it tastes really good inside. So there you have it, guys. Based on this set of experiments, I'd say the Random Blaster 5000 has proven itself to be a major player. By the way, if you wanna go check out Mark's original video, I will put his link down in the description. You can go say hi and tell him Grant sent you. We shot watermelons, blasted through the rinds, we punctured soda cans, and we chopped hot dogs clean in half. And now that Mark Rober and I both have two of the world's largest water guns, what do you guys think we should do with them? Post your comments and suggestions down below. Hey, thanks for joining me for this video. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. My sweat tastes like root beer. Hey guys, this was a huge team effort. I certainly did not make this by myself. I had a lot of people working in the background to make this project possible. First of all, I want to say thank you to Nate. He was the guy who actually put all the foam together and made this look as good as it did. Ben Watkins helped collect all the materials for the inside, the pressure tanks, the pressure hoses, and made that possible. And a big shout out to my friends at Kuma Films who came by with their Phantom and provided some of those super slow motion shots. You can check out Kuma Films in the description below. Hey guys, I want you to be some of the first to see my next video. If you haven't already, click subscribe and ring the bell. By ringing the bell, you'll get a post notification the next time I post a video. So click subscribe, ring the bell, and I'll see you in the next video.